Hey guys, Corey here. Last job of the day here. Getting ready to start a six-roomer with a couple of closets and maybe a little hallway or something here. It's not, overall, it's not terribly dirty. It's got some tricky spots in it that I think should all come out okay. Maybe two or three might not. Let's take a look here where they're vacuuming in the back right now. So I'm gonna take a look at the first three and we'll take a look at the other three shortly after they're done. I'm up here in the very front of the house in the, I guess it would be an office or something. It's probably where this, I'm sure this was set up as an office here. It's got some interesting stuff going on in it. I don't really know exactly what any of it is. I guess maybe it, ink or something possibly, especially something like that. It's like multiple colored, I don't know. Then we've got this here. Most likely that, I can probably lighten it up, but that's probably permanent. At least this one for sure, that one maybe, that one might come out. This, Lord even know, who knows. It'll probably come out. And here, some more of that fancy stuff I was talking about. I don't have any idea what that is. It's gonna be a two-part thing. It'll be a rosin and a dye. If both of them come out, that'd be great. But yeah, somebody has had after the carpet with a marker, it looks like. Children and markers. That's just, they make washable markers, and let's hope that that's what this is. It's a washable marker, because they come out a whole lot easier than permanent do. And this room here, and we're running the vacuum in the back, so let's see if we can take a look. All right, this one here, a little probably ink, and one more. I guess it was kids with markers or something.
What is it?
I guess it was kids with markers or something.
Yeah, kids, they did some work.
Yeah, they had fun in one of the rooms up toward the front.
They
really made it pretty colors, man.
Yeah.
Hopefully I can get all that out. All right, I'm going to start in the last room that we were in. All right, I just want to go over some of the pre-spotting here. These areas that I expect so much trouble out of, they've been treated twice with clear ammonia. They are lightening up some. However, I'm not expecting, these look like they're lightening up some, but they're not gonna go anywhere. Add heat or not, they're not gonna go anywhere. It's gotta be a permanent marker. Anyway, I've got the living room sprayed and two rooms are done. So this one's ready to be cleaned right now. This is the area that has been cleaned. This room, the master closet, and this room here. And everything came out just fine so far, so it looks like the most difficult is yet to come. Luckily not the whole room, just a few trouble spots in each room. So I'm gonna clean here, we'll check in after I clean this room. Now this is the part that I was expecting so much trouble with, and I've amazed myself with ammonia one more time. This is where the bright pink or red and blue and everything was at. I treated it with ammonia about three times. Every time I treated it, it got a little lighter. Then when I hit it with a machine, it knocked it right out of there. It's just, I can't even believe it, really. It looked like permanent marker. It may have been permanent marker, and the pH in the ammonia was just high enough to knock it out of there. No heat was added whatsoever, just ammonia. The only thing that I can say maybe different is it wasn't really the yellow. I started out with yellow ammonia and I kept adding clear ammonia. I was using it in all these different spots here that had the red and a different colored dyes. So every time I would add to it, I would add clear ammonia. So I'm thinking that the clear ammonia is just a little stronger, or the pH is a little higher in the clear ammonia than the yellow. So I'm thinking the yellow is more your friend. The clear is more your friend than the yellow is. But this, I can't believe it's turning out this well. That before I began, I thought that was definitely a patch that was permanent, that wouldn't come out with heat transfer or anything. Straight ammonia did it. All right, two more to go. I'm gonna re-up my sprayer. Then we're gonna clean these two. And these two have been doing the same thing with them. You still see a little yellow in it, but it's clear that I've been adding to it and just continuing to do basically this right here, just soak it with this after every room. Try to go, you can see there's marker where kids have got marker on it. It knocks all of that out. And all of this in here, I'm thinking all of this will come out all right. Been having such good luck already. Not expecting to have all that much trouble in here. Anyway, that's amazing. As long as I've been doing this, I'm still learning new stuff about simple cleaning products. Alright, I will check back in here in a bit. I'm going to show the cleaning of these two rooms since I haven't shown anything yet. take a look back at that in a minute. One to go here, and this one, it's looking clean already because I groomed everything in. But here it comes. I'm gonna groom this one. Take a quick look here in a minute. All right, this is the last room. This one was the one that I thought was maybe the worst. It came out just great. I used extra peroxide, basically, and Simple Green. Those two components only, and using just clear ammonia to treat everything inorganic. And by inorganic, I mean dyes and stuff. It's the only thing I couldn't get out. And that right there, that's just nuts. I can't believe that it came out like that. Wow. All right, guys, that is the last one of the day here. I'm gonna pack it up and head to the house before the next big thunderstorm catches me. I didn't think ammonia would do that today. It's weird how you have those days where everything seems to fall into place and other days when things just don't. You know, you can't expect every cleaning to work out the same because there's variables that happen to the carpet before you get there. So this is just an exceptional case of having everything just kind of fall into place wherever you want it to. Anyway, this cleaning went wonderfully. Thanks for watching. If you have questions, you're always welcome to text 512-350-1129. And if you're local, I can help you. Thanks for watching. God bless.